Now let us discuss measurement of another important non-electrical quantity, that is velocity or speed. So let us say measurement of velocity or speed. So now, similar to displacement, there are two types of velocity or speed which we can measure. One is linear velocity and another one is angular velocity. So therefore, let us discuss first measurement of linear velocity. So in order to measure linear velocity, basically there are two types of transducers are available. One is electromagnetic transducer and another one is seismic type transducer. Again, there are two types of electromagnetic transducers. One is moving magnetic type and moving coil type electromagnetic transducers. So let us discuss first electromagnetic transducer. So an electromagnetic transducer utilizes the voltage produced in a coil on account of change in the flux linkages resulting from change in reluctance. So this is the most commonly used transducer for the measurement of linear velocity. So therefore, let us discuss about the two types of electromagnetic transducers, that is moving magnet type and moving coil type. Now let us see moving magnet type electromagnetic transducer. So as the name itself suggests, it is a moving magnet type. That means the magnet is moving here. So this is the diagram. It consists of a permanent magnet as a core, which is movable one. So the permanent magnet is connected to the rod whose velocity is to be, or linear velocity is to be measured. Now around this permanent magnet, the coils are wound. So now when this magnet, permanent magnet, moves inside the coil, so the voltage is induced in the coil. So it works on the principle that whenever there is a magnetic movement in the coil, so the voltage is induced in the coil. So here the voltage induced in the coil is directly proportional to the velocity of the magnetic movement. So as the magnet moves with a faster rate, more amount of voltage can be induced in the coil. So in this case, the amount of voltage induced is given by an expression E is equal to B into A into N into V. Here B is the flux density, which is constant for a given permanent magnet. A is area of the coil, which is also constant here for a given coil. N is number of turns of the coil. The number of turns is also fixed for a particular coil. And V is the relative velocity of the magnet with respect to coil, so which is variable. So therefore, the amount of induced voltage is directly proportional to the velocity of the magnet with respect to coil. So as the velocity increases, the voltage induced increases. So therefore, the linear velocity is measured in terms of induced voltage in the coil. Now let us discuss about measurement of angular velocity. So angular velocity can be measured with an instrument called as tachometer. So a tachometer can be defined as an instrument which either continuously indicates the value of rotary speed or continuously displays a reading of average speed over rapidly operated short intervals of time. Tachometer can also be defined as an instrument used for the measurement of angular velocity as of shaft, either by registering the total number of revolutions during the period of contact or by indicating directly the number of revolutions per minute. So now there are two types of tachometers. Tachometers can be mainly classified into two types, that is mechanical tachometers and electrical tachometers. So again, there are different types of mechanical tachometers, that are hand speed indicator, revolution counter and timer, tachoscope, centrifugal tachometers, vibrating reed tachometers, and so on. Similarly, there are different types of electrical tachometers also, such as DC tachometer generator, AC tachometer generator, photoelectric tachometers, eddy current or drag cup tachometers, capacitive tachometers, and stroboscopic tachometers, and so on. So among these electrical tachometers, already we have discussed some of the tachometers in the previous modules. So here mainly let us focus on DC tachometer generator and AC tachometer generator. So here we are going to discuss about electrical tachometers. Now let us discuss about electrical tachometers. So for the measurement of angular velocity or angular speed, electrical tachometers are preferred over mechanical tachometers, because in case of electrical tachometers, the angular velocity is converted into an electrical signal or an electrical parameter, so which may give the accurate value of angular velocity. So as we have discussed, there are two main types of electrical tachometers. One is DC tachometer generator, another one is AC tachometer generator. So let us see first DC tachometer generator. In a DC tachometer generator, the EMF generated depends upon mainly two factors. One is field excitation, second one is speed. Now suppose if we keep the field excitation constant, then the EMF or voltage generated will be directly proportional to speed of the shaft which is to be measured. So therefore, in case of a DC tachometer, the speed or angular velocity or angular speed is converted into a varying voltage or varying EMF. So that variable EMF or voltage is measured, which gives directly the value of angular velocity or angular speed. So here, this is the diagram of a DC tachometer. It consists of a shaft whose speed is to be measured. So this shaft is connected to armature, and then these are the brushes of the armature. So this is kept, armature is kept in between the permanent magnets, the two poles of the permanent magnet. So there is a constant flux or constant field excitation. So now when the shaft rotates, the armature also rotates, so EMF will be induced across the brushes, so which is connected to a moving coil voltmeter through variable resistor. So whenever the armature rotates, it induces voltage across the brush, and that can be measured by using voltmeter. As the angular velocity increases, the voltage or EMF developed also increases. So therefore, here the EMF induced or voltage induced is directly proportional to the angular velocity. A variable resistor is used here in order to limit the flow of current to the voltmeter. So in this way, the angular speed or angular velocity can be measured by means of DC tachometer generator. Now let us discuss about AC tachometer generator. So this AC tachometer generator, it overcomes the problems associated with DC tachometer generator due to the presence of commutator and brushes. So this is the diagram of AC tachometer generator. It consists of a stator coil and a rotor. So its construction is like an alternator. So it has a stationary armature which is stator and a rotating field system that is rotor. So in order to generate an EMF in the stationary coil, that is stator coil, the rotor rotates. The shaft whose angular velocity is to be measured is connected to the rotor. So as the rotor rotates, the EMF will be induced in the stator coil. So now the induced EMF in the stationary coil, that is stator coil, is an alternating EMF. So here the alternating EMF developed across the stator coil is converted into DC voltage by means of a bridge rectifier. So this bridge rectifier converts an AC voltage into DC voltage, and the ripple content present in the DC voltage is removed by means of capacitor filter, and that converted DC voltage is measured with the help of moving coil voltmeter. So now the voltage induced in this voltage shown by this moving coil voltmeter is directly proportional to the velocity of the shaft, the angular velocity of the shaft. As this velocity increases, more amount of voltage will be induced across the stator coil. So therefore the voltage shown by this voltmeter will be more. So in this way, here this AC tachometer generator generates an AC voltage which is directly proportional to the angular velocity of the shaft. So now this is about the DC tachometer generator and AC tachometer generator, which are the main types of electrical tachometers which are used to measure angular velocity. Now there are other methods of other types of electrical tachometers are also present, that is photoelectric tachometers, eddy current or drag cup tachometer, capacitive tachometer and stroboscopic tachometers. So these working of these tachometers already we have discussed in the previous module. So therefore it is not necessary to once again repeat the same things here. So here mainly we have focused on DC tachometer generator and AC tachometer generator.